Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss what are the different methods to reduce the armature reaction. So last class we have seen what is armature reaction. Armature reaction is the effect of armature flux on the main field flux, and we have seen that because of the armature reaction, I am just trying to revise what we have learned in last class. We have seen that because of the armature reaction, so there are two fluxes that are available. One is because of the main field flux and the second one is because of the armature flux. Because there is an armature MMF wave because of the current passing through the armature conductors. As a resultant of this, the net flux is not becoming equal to zero at the geometrical neutral axis or your brush axis where your brush is kept. At that point, your net flux is not becoming equal to zero. Your net flux at that point will be equal to this much. So your net flux is this much. But because of this, what happens? The EMF will not be equal to zero for the conductor which is under this conductor. So because of this, the commutation process delays, which causes the sparking at the brushes. This is the first effect we have seen. And the second effect is, as the more flux is concentrated at the trailing pole tip, because of this your core goes into saturation, so the amount of flux that is produced at this point will decrease. As a result of this, the net flux, the total sum of the flux under each pole, will decrease. As effect of this, the average value of the EMF decreases and torque decreases in the case of motor. And the third effect we have seen, because of this high value of flux concentrated at one point, it induces so much value of the voltage, the conductor which is coming under this. If the voltage crosses the limit of your mica insulation may damage, that leads to short circuiting of your commutator segments. That will damage your segments. So the final solution for this is, I have to decrease the maximum value of the flux that is concentrated at this point. The flux should uniformly distribute, resultant flux, and at the geometrical neutral axis, I want my resultant flux should be equal to zero. So how to make the resultant flux equal to zero? Because we know the resultant flux is the sum of the main field flux and the armature flux. This is my armature flux. So this is one component, and the second component is this one. So this is another component, and we know at this geometrical neutral axis already the main field MMF is zero. So I want my armature flux should be equal to zero. I want to make my armature flux should be equal to zero. How this can be obtained? By keeping some extra field in such a way that will make my armature flux is equal to zero, or produce some extra flux which will be exactly counterbalancing this armature flux, so that whatever is the value here, same thing will be there in the armature flux. So as a result of this, so this one and this one will cancel each other. So this is done by using interpoles. This we are going to see in detail. And the next one, another way is, you can shift your main field MMF in such a way, the main field MMF will not become zero at this point. It will become zero before itself. That means this, whatever is the curve here, this curve I will distribute like this. This should shift from here to like this point, and it will be negative at this point, such that the value of the negative main field MMF will be equal to armature MMF wave. In that case also, the net MMF or the net flux at this point will be equal to zero. That means what I have to do, whatever is the main field flux, it should not become zero at the place of MNA. It should become zero before the geometrical neutral axis. When it is zero before the geometrical neutral axis, at geometrical neutral axis, the resultant MMF can be, resultant flux can be made equal to zero. In that way also, we can avoid this delayed commutation and other things. How this can be obtained? So this can be obtained using two techniques. So those things also we are going to see. So let us try to summarize. So if you want to decrease my armature reaction, I want that at the geometrical neutral axis, I want my resultant flux should be equal to zero. So that can be obtained either by keeping some extra winding in such a way that it compensate my armature MMF, or design the main field flux in such a way, main field flux poles in such a way that the flux zero will happen before the geometrical neutral axis, and at the geometrical neutral axis, the flux produced by the main field flux will be exactly counterbalancing the armature flux. So using that also we can obtain. So with these basics, let us proceed further and see the different methods of decreasing the armature reaction. So the first method is by using high reluctance pole tips. By using high reluctance pole tips. So what will be done there? We know that our pole is generally designed like this. So if this is my rotor, your poles are designed in such a way that they will spread your flux uniformly. But I want that, because previously what is happening, up to that instant, this up to this instant to this instant the flux is uniform. After that it will gradually reach zero at your magnetic neutral axis. But now I want that zero should happen before, and as you are going from the center, I want my flux to distribute in such a way it will become zero before itself. How that can be obtained? The first technique is by using high reluctance pole tip. So how it will be done? Your pole will be constructed of two separate laminations. One will cover the left one and the second lamination will be covering the right side. So these laminations are kept like that. First this lamination will be kept and above this second, and above this again first one, then second one. Like that alternately they are kept. And if this is viewed from the top, you will see it like this. First this lamination that I am just explaining for the case of pole tip. So if you see from the top, you will observe first the lamination 1 is kept. So after this lamination 2 is kept. This is lamination 2. Again lamination 1. And again lamination 2. Like that your pole is constructed. As a result of this, you can see in the center it is we are having the complete metal, so automatically the reluctance is less. But as you are going to the pole tips, there is an air gap. Because of this air gap, the reluctance will increase. Whenever the reluctance is increased, because when you make the winding like this on your pole, depending on how much value of current you are passing and how many number of conductors are there, we know the flux is equal to MMF divided by reluctance. MMF is equal to N into I divided by reluctance. If reluctance is more, then flux will be less. If reluctance is less, then flux will be more. So in the center, the flux will be more. As you are going to the pole tips, the flux will decrease. So this is what we want. So this will be obtained. So I am just trying to draw it here. So let us assume this is my brush axis. So the flux will be like that. So it will not be uniform at this point. It will increase like this. It will increase like this. And it will become zero before your geometric neutral axis. This is my GNA. So at the geometric neutral axis, this will be negative. So that whatever the flux is produced because of the armature, let us assume this is produced because of armature, this is produced because of the main field, both will compensate each other, and so that the net flux will be zero at geometric neutral axis. This is the first way in which we can get. But there is a disadvantage of this. As you are providing the high reluctance path, so in order to produce the same flux, you have to pass either increase the current or increase the number of turns to get the same average flux. Flux per pole, if you want to get the same flux per pole, because now the reluctance is increased because of this type of structure. So to compensate is either you have to increase the current or you have to increase the number of turns. But it is not so much use, so there will be no effect of this. And the second type of technique, because this technique is generally used in synchronous machines to get sinusoidal distribution, that is by chamfered poles. What is the meaning of chamfering? Let us assume this is my rotor. Okay, let us assume this. If you want to maintain the equally gap, you have to keep your pole like this. So you will not keep your pole like this. You will not keep the pole like this. You will keep in some different way. So how you will keep this? So again, I am just drawing it here. So your pole will be constructed like this. That means, here whatever gap is there, let us assume A, here the gap is B. So always the gap B is greater than A. So this is called as chamfering of the poles. But in this case, whatever is A and in the end B. So A is equal to B. When A is equal to B, at every point the flux will be uniform. But in this case, as B is more, that means the reluctance is more. As the reluctance is more, automatically the flux will be less. That means most of the flux that is generated will be concentrated in the center. As you are going away, the flux will decrease. So using that also, we can get the zero before this. This is the second technique. Now, the third one, the third technique is by creating holes in the armature flux path holes in the armature flux path. So how to do this? This is my fold. This is my armature. So let us assume this is my north pole. So we have already seen that this is my geometrical neutral axis. These are my conductors. We know whichever conductors are coming under north pole, they will always induce the cross when your machine is rotating in clockwise direction. Similarly, whichever conductors comes under south pole, they will induce a dot. So the net resultant direction of the flux produced by this can be found by using right hand thumb rule. If you apply it, your curled finger indicates the direction of your current, then your thumb indicates the direction of the magnetic field. So using this, if you substitute, so you will get that your direction of the field produced will be like this. Okay, this flux should have the return path. Always the plus flux always prefers the low reluctance path, right? So this is my flux path. So the amount of flux, armature flux that is produced, again armature flux is equal to armature MMF IA into number of conductors divided by the reluctance. So if I can increase my reluctance, automatically the armature flux decreases. So I want to decrease my armature flux, so that, because we know the resultant flux will be, this is my main field flux and this is my armature flux. The resultant MMF A will be phi R. So if this phi A can be decreased, so automatically this resultant will shift upwards, or the magnetic neutral axis and the geometrical neutral axis will try to coincide with each other, because as per initial condition, this is like this. This is my magnetic neutral axis. So magnetic neutral axis, if you are decreasing the value of phi A, automatically, because this resultant value is shifted upwards, or we can tell that your magnetic neutral axis will shift like this. So that is what I want. So to get this, I have to increase the reluctance. How to increase the reluctance? What I do, I make the holes to this pole core. If I create the holes in the pore core, because this is made up of air, so it has the high reluctance. So automatically the flux, the net resultant flux produced by your armature will decrease. So this is the second technique. And the next technique is by using interpoles. So interpoles, the name itself is telling, between two poles we keep another pole. So let us go back to this curve again so that we can try to analyze this. So I have gone back to this one. So you can see, under normal condition, this is at geometrical neutral axis. This is my value of armature flux. This is my value of armature flux, and the flux produced by the main poles is zero. So I want to make this zero. The armature flux is zero, and also we have discussed there the amount of armature flux is proportional to the current passing through the armature, and the current passing through the armature depends on the load. That means when the load is changing, automatically the flux will change, so it is not constant. So you have to design the compensation in such a way, you have to keep produce some flux which is exactly opposite to this armature flux, and it will be always same. That means whatever is the armature flux produced, same flux should be produced by this. How can I keep it? Because here you can see, this is a north pole. So I want, if I keep a south pole means the flux will be negative, and that should get exactly same flux as your armature flux, so that it will compensate. So how I can get from this? Because here the north pole is produced because of your armature. So I want a south pole. So what I do, I keep one pole here, a south pole. So this south pole, what I do, I make the connection and connect this in series with your armature. So armature current only will pass through this. The number of turns will be designed in such a way, it will exactly counterbalance your armature MMF. So because of this south pole, what happens? This south pole and this north pole, both will cancel each other, or the both the fluxes produced by the armature and your interpole will cancel each other. So how to keep that interpole? So in general, because we know the generator will rotate in the clockwise direction, the polarity of the interpole will be the polarity of the pole that is going to come next. The polarity of the interpole will be the polarity of the pole that is going to come next. So that pole, that way we have to keep. That means, so I am going back to this by using the interpole. So what is the interpole? Interpole is kept at geometrical neutral axis, and this will be connected in series with the armature, so that the flux produced by this interpole, I am representing with phi ip, will be exactly equal to flux produced by the armature, so that the resultant flux, which is the sum of main field flux plus interpole plus phi a, will be only equal to the main field flux. That means these two will cancel each other. In that way we have to design the pole. Getting it? And the pole which is coming should be like that. If this is my rotor, if this is my generator, here there is a north pole, here there is a south pole, the interpole polarity will be the pole that is going to come next. The next, that means after rotation of some distance, south pole is coming, so this will be south pole. I am only discussing for the case of generator only. For the motor, the direction of the motor is different, but the way you make the winding, other things are same. So I am only discussing for generator to avoid the confusion. Always the interpole, the polarity is such that whichever pole is coming to come next, it will have the same polarity. Okay. Next one, the fifth method is by using compensating winding. By using compensating winding. So, using compensating winding, the effect of armature reaction under main poles will be compensated. The effect will be compensated using this. So, where this is used? The compensating winding is a costly affair. Generally, the compensating winding is used in machines where there are more fluctuations in your load. Only where there are more fluctuations, only there we go for the compensating winding. Let us see what is compensating winding and why it should be used in that particular case. So I am taking my north pole, I have taken my south pole, and this is my rotor. Let us assume this is my north pole, this is my south pole. Automatically this is my, this is geometrical neutral axis. I am just erasing it to avoid confusion. So this is geometrical neutral axis. So these are my armature conductors. So whichever conductors are under the north pole, cross is induced in them. And whichever conductors are under the south pole, a dot is induced in them. Because of this, we can see that the flux, the field will be produced in such a way that if I draw the field because of them, the field will be produced in such a way it will be downwards here. And similarly, the field will pass in this direction. This also will be like this. This is my flux because of the armature. Flux because of the armature. So, this is also flux because of the armature. I want to nullify the effect of this armature. How can I nullify it? So, I can keep some winding in such a way that will produce a flux which is exactly opposite to this, and that will depend on same way, it should be in series with your armature, so that same armature current will pass and we can nullify the effect. So what we do, we keep the winding here inside your pole shoe, because making the hole and keeping the winding is a costly affair. That's why this is only used in the special cases where the fluctuating loads are there and it is really essential. So that thing we want to see now. So here I pass the current in such a way, the current direction will be opposite here. So here there will be dot and here there will be cross. Again, because of this, again some flux is produced. This induces the flux which will be exactly opposite direction to your, this will induce the flux exactly opposite in direction to your armature flux. That means this also will induce exactly opposite direction to your armature flux. This will be exactly opposite direction to your armature flux. So this I can write as compensating flux, and this is my direction of the armature flux. So both will cancel each other. That is my basic concept. Okay, as a result of this, that effect is nullified. So where this is required and what is the need of this compensating winding? So that I am going to tell you now. So whenever the load is suddenly fluctuating, when the load is suddenly fluctuating, automatically the current passing through your armature is changing. When the current passing through the armature is changing suddenly, so di by dt will induce a self-induced EMF, because every conductor will have the inductance. So L into di by dt will give a self-induced EMF inside the conductors. So this self-induced EMF may add to your dynamically induced EMF. If this self-induced EMF is added to the dynamically induced EMF, so automatically what will happen? The huge value of voltage is coming, and this may spoil your mica insulation. This may spoil your mica insulation and lead to short circuit of commutator. I am repeating again. Whenever the current or the load is suddenly changed due to the inductance of your coil L into di by dt, that creates the self-induced EMF. If this self-induced EMF is aiding your dynamically induced EMF or rotationally induced EMF, so the net EMF can increase. Because of the increase in the EMF, the mica insulation may damage in the commutator, and this leads to short circuit of your commutator, or your entire machine will spoil. In order to avoid this, always whenever there is a change, sudden change in the flux in this, that there should be another winding which will produce the flux in such a way it will compensate each other. Which will compensate each other. That means whenever this is suddenly changing, so this produces some flux, and here also this produces another flux, both will compensate each other, and the net resultant effect will be cancelled. So this will lead to saving of your commutator segments. Okay, I hope it is clear up to now. We have seen the different ways. The first way is by making your main field flux zero before your magnetic neutral axis, and at the magnetic neutral axis the flux produced by the main field flux should exactly opposite your armature flux. So using that, we can make the geometrical neutral axis coincide with your magnetic neutral axis. So to get it, so we have seen two different techniques. The first thing is using the chamfering of the poles, and the second one we have seen using the high reluctance pole tips. This is the second one. And coming to the armature side, to decrease the armature flux, so to decrease the armature flux so that the resultant flux will be inclined towards your geometrical neutral axis, we make the holes in the main field core so that the armature, the reluctance for the armature flux will increase and that will be less. So that is first one we have seen. And the second one we have seen, second method is using interpoles. Using interpoles, and the interpoles will be connected in series with the armature, so that the net resultant flux at the geometrical neutral axis will be equal to zero because of the armature flux. And the third technique is using the interpoles, compensating winding. The compensating winding is made inside your main pole core shoe, and main pole shoe, the winding is the main purpose is, it is mainly used when there are variable loads, because whenever the load changes because of change in current, a self-induced EMF will be induced that may aid to the dynamical induced EMF and spoil your commutator. To compensate that, we go for compensating winding. So compensating winding mainly compensates for two things. One is compensation of the effect of armature flux on the main field flux under the pole shoe, and the second one is decrease the effect of the self-induced EMF under load fluctuation conditions. I hope this is clear up to now. So next class we are going to see what will be the effect of brush shift, because we know that this is my main field flux and this is my armature flux. Because of this shift in the resultant flux, your magnetic neutral axis is shifted from your geometrical neutral axis. We know as it is shifted at this point, the EMF is not equal to zero under the conductor under the brush. That leads to sparking. In order to avoid the sparking, we have to shift your brushes to the magnetic neutral axis. So if you shift your brush towards the magnetic neutral axis, so what will be the effect and how to overcome the things? Those things we are going to see in the next class. So if you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. Thank you. Thank you very much.